ಓಂ ಸದಾಶಿವಸಮಾರಂಭಾಂ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಮಧ್ಯಮ ಅಸ್ಮದಾಚಾರ್ಯಪರ್ಯಂತಾ ವಂದೇ ಗುರು ಪರಂಪರಾ. ಗುರುರ್ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಗುರುರ್ವಿಷ್ಣು ಗುರುರ್ದೇವೋ ಮಹೇಶ್ವರ ಗುರುರ್ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಪರಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ತಸ್ಮೈ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರವೇ ನಮಃ. ಸಮಸ್ತಜನಕಲ್ಯಾಣೇ ನಿರತಂ ಕರುಣಾಮಯಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಚಿನ್ಮಯಂ ದೇವಂ ಸದ್ಗುರುಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವಿದ್ವರಂ. ಹರಿ ಓಂ. ಜನರಲಿ ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ಲಿ. ದನ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಯು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡೌಟ್ ಯಾ ಮೀ ವೈ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಯಾ ಐ ಫೀಲ್ ಎಲಿವೇಟೆಡ್. Therefore, I am going to Upanishad class. I attended Kindle Life, Self-Unfoldment, studied Atmabodha, Tattvabodha, Vivekachudamani, almost all the texts in 1 year. So I am ready, the fit student, to study Upanishad. Yeah. Therefore, I registered my name. Now I am here. I do not know because of my karma or by grace of the Lord. Anyway, I am here. You don't worry about all those things. Anyway, you are here by God's grace, not by karma. Grace is very important. Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya also says, Manushyattu Mamukshyattu Mahapurusha Samsaraya. To get the Manushya Janma, Mahapurusha Mamukshyattu, want to get liberation from the problems and worries. At the same time, we have to get the realized master. We are under his umbrella, Swami Chinmayanji. See, the Ganga flows from the Himalayas and goes to plains, serves the humanity, not only humanity, other living beings also. How it serves Ganga. The same way our Gurudev brought this Upanishad Bhagavad Gita to us. So all the dry land will becoming what is that? Very prosperous land. The same way, our mind and intellect also very, very dry mind, dry intellect. Agitated mind and confused intellect. So we have to get prosperity at inner level. For that we need to have what is this kind of self-knowledge. Self-knowledge is Jnana Ganga. So we have to see his compassionate heart. Samasta jana kalyane niratam karunamaya. Gurudev is great. Karunamurti. So when I met him first in 1993, attracted by his beauty, his English, powerful personality. Then I studied this Upanishad Bhagavad Gita and all 3 year Vedanta course. And attracted by his knowledge. Then after many, many years, this person is very knowledge-oriented, not very compassionate, and not loving. Because only once I met him, that's all. I felt like that. Because if you are very compassionate, you have to cry, no? You have to cry. And you have to speak very softly. Oh, like this. But whenever you watch Gurudev's lectures, very thunderbolt. Huh. Then after many, many years, they understood the compassion means there's no need of flow of tears from the eyes. Without the eyes also, the heart can be very compassionate. Many, many years it took to understand the compassionate heart. Because he loved us so much, compassionate heart, he brought this knowledge to us. I have seen one fruit in California. This is not available here, but you can imagine. You are very familiar with the tomato, huh? Say yes. Yes, yes, tomato. You are very familiar. Exactly, it looks like tomato. Tomato outside, the structure, color, everything. But inside, sometimes tomato is very sour. Inside. But this fruit is exactly looks like tomato. And inside, extraordinary sweet, and the fragrance you get. This is called persimmon. Persimmon, and it's available only in California. To eat this, you try to go to California. Or if you go there, you call for this fruit. How? Inside. But you will not get fragrance outside. Outside you will not get fragrance. So I feel this Gurudev is like that. Outside there is no tears in his eyes and all. Outside is very beautiful personality, inside sweetest heart. Oh, giving this knowledge. When you go through Upanishad, Bhagavad Gita, the information, the message, how it helps. When I study Bhagavadam, you also study Bhagavadam. Our Vidura did not participate in 18 days war. He went away because Duryodhana insulted him like anything. He went away. He broke his bow and went away. And he did this a lot of for that. He visited a lot of Punyakshetras, Kshetradana. Came back and he come to understand that all, the whole Kaurava family, Kaurava clan, was washed away from the earth. Pandavas won the game. Pandavas won the war. So when he heard this news of Mahabharata, everything washed away, including Duryodhana, everybody died. He felt very, very bad, and he wanted to cry loudly. Bhagavan Vedavyasa says in Bhagavan that he controlled complete his worries because of the self-knowledge. Through self-knowledge only he overcame this kind of worries and the tragedies. When you read this kind of histories, we can understand with the self-knowledge we can overcome even death also. Very powerful knowledge. I did a few years back this same place, Brahma Sutra. When I was going through the Brahma Sutra thoughts, again there also I felt Gurudev's the great work. Generally, social work means what? 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 Giving food. Giving food. Giving food. You give food. Shelter, cloth, some cyclone comes, earthquake comes, tsunami comes. You go to the spot immediately, emotionally. You're going to help them. Giving food, shelter, everything, medicine, everything you give. And name also comes in the paper, first page. You give post also. Right. Very great service this person has done, and he has donated this much crore rupees, this and that. Generally, service to the humanity means giving food, shelter, cloth. Very, very popular. And the people, those who are doing this kind of service, they are getting praise, the Nobel Prize and so many great praise also. Here, this kind of service is, what that? It's very, very little, very, not little, very subtle kind of service. The person is very rich outside, having all kinds of comforts, but inside is suffering like anything. Generally, we say a poor person. Poor person means not that. It doesn't mean that he is not having any comforts. Even though he has got all kinds of comforts in his life, poor person means he is suffering inside. You got the idea? Suffering inside. Confusion, the intellectual level. The mind level, complete sufferings. To remove this kind of sufferings, this kind of confusion, we need to have knowledge. Gurudev brought this knowledge from Himalayas for the poor person, even though he has got, what that? The rich person, he has got the name of rich person outside. Outside is very rich, inside the poorest person. But this kind of person, bringing this knowledge, serving him by giving the knowledge is the greatest service. You agree? This kind of service is not seen outside. Subtle kind of service. And people will not understand this also. If you give the food, shelter, and all the cloth, seen outside, and they appreciate like anything. So this kind of service is not seen outside. It's very difficult to understand also. But this is a very subtlest service. You got it? So Gurudev brought this Bhagavad Gita Upanishad for us, how to remove our worries and confusions from our inner personality. Powerful service. Yeah, powerful service. We will get out of our, what is that, the poverty inside, and we will become rich personalities in this world. Even though we have very little, what is that, the comfort outside. The richest person in the world has got the mental peace and clear intellect. You agree? Please agree. Powerful service. To understand this or that, what I shared with you, it took long time for me. Oh, so many years. I also used to ask the same question. All rich people used to go to Chinmaya Mission. All rich people. They're coming in the car, sitting in the AC room. Very nice, comfortable chair. Listen to English lecture. You're getting it? I also had the same thought. Even though I had the same thought, I was serving this mission. Yeah. So one side I had this doubt. Other side, let this doubt be there. And you serve at the same time. When time comes, God will give nice clarity. Got it. Powerful service Gurudev is doing. Around the world, wherever you go, the people are giving this lecture or getting the information of Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad, all because of Swami Chinmayananda. Yeah, you can say. Around the world. Whoever gives this knowledge, whoever receives this knowledge, because of him. After independence, he brought this, 1951 he started, and shared this knowledge around the world. More than 6 decades serving the humanity through this Bhagavad Gita and Upanishad. Okay? Shall we enter into this Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad? Yeah. So only one qualification is needed in this Upanishad. What is that? Should not sleep. But it's very difficult. So more than 10 days I had this problem of cough and cold. Anyway, till yesterday I was a little worrying. How can I manage? 4 hours per day? By God's grace, I got the ability today. I can manage. Okay? So anyway, 5-6 days. This will be okay. I will not ask you any question I know. No question, no homework. Okay? Be relaxed and listen. If you have a question, you write it down. In between class, please don't ask question. Okay? I know you will not ask. End of the class, we'll have discussion. Because when Gurudev started giving this lecture in Upanishad, powerful personality, realized master, great English, reaching out from the Atma Shakti, he was talking. We are all very small. When we give a lecture, people started sleeping. So what to do? Little more flavor to be added. Okay? See the Apple computer? Computer and PPT and some colorful slides also I brought. I try my best to do, what is that? Best. Colorfully you will learn this Upanishad. Okay? See, you take notes. After this slides also I will give you information. Take the notes. Then after the class, I will send you this PPT to you. Okay? Shall we start? Yes. Very interesting Upanishad. No confusion. No confusion. No, I'm not telling other Upanishads are confused. Not like that. All the Upanishads are very, very high level. But if you go to... Ishavashya, Sambhudi, Asambhudi. Little more time is needed to understand there. There's a part, difficult part. Kero Upanishad, the beginning itself, Mandukya, ayyo. Kato Upanishad, very easy. Easy flow. easy flow. I start with story. The Mundakopanishad is easy flow. If you go to Prashnopanishad, 5 questions, 5 different, different level. Oh. Little we need to have more effort to understand. Here there is no need to effort. They take effort. Just to, as a flow, so our mind understands many, many, very easily. Okay? Yeah. Can you say this? Good. Bhagavan Vedavyasa. This is very popular. Bhagavan Vedavyasa. He compiled all the Vedic mantras from the great rishis. Hundreds of rishis lived in the forest of Bharat, Bharatavarsha. In those days, just lived in the forest. The deep meditation, realized souls. So many mantras revealed to them. They taught these mantras to the students. Intern students also became guru. And they also taught their students like this, Guru Parampara. They heard this, and after that they passed it on to their students. They heard, passed. That's why this is called Shruti. Vid. Veda. Vid. Vid means the root word is vid, to know. Or the treasure of knowledge is called Vedas. It is revealed to great rishis. Hundreds of rishis. Bhagavan Vedavyasa, he took very powerful project that he collected all the Vedic mantras from all the rishis. Compiled. Rig, Yaju, Sama, Atharvan. So to do this kind of work, Lord Vishnu has to take avatar. Yeah, Lord Vishnu has to take. Suppose I give you 10 page, what that? One article I give you. For the story's sake, I'm telling. Just I'll give you one 10-page article. Whatever I thought, I brought all ideas and give it to you. You're also going through that. You don't understand what I thought. No connection between one paragraph to other paragraph. What are the thought, set of thoughts I got? I just brought everything. But you have to study everything. And you have to rearrange all the thoughts and you have to make it as a very nice article. Just a 10-page, just to think. 10 pages of the article. How long it takes to rearrange and make a very nice article. Can you understand? Just a 10-page. 2-3 months it will take. Sometimes you will tear and put it in the dustbin also. Very difficult process. Think of the rishis, Veda mantras, collected everything, compiled. The greatest work Bhagavan Vedavyasa has done. Because of him only, the Sanatana Dharma survives. If Vedavyasa Bhagavan, he must not have done it, we would have not received this Sanatana Dharma. Sanatana Dharma would have washed away, finished. It's a pillar. And is a founder. We cannot say founder. He compiled and re-established the Sanatana Dharma. Powerful work he did. And he has given the name Yurgyaju Samatranavid. It will take long time to go through this Veda. Study a Veda. At least we know the 4 names. Yurgyaju Samatranavid. We got 20 marks also for this question. When you study in school, how many Vedas? 4. What are they? 20 marks. What it has? I do not know. But great scholars, but they, what is it? They share. So what it has? They studied and they spent a lot of time. Bhagavan Vedavyasa would have compiled these Vedas. And Rig Veda is given to his student Paila Rishi. Yajur Veda is given to Vaishampayana. And Jaimini has taken Sama Veda. Sumanta has taken Atharana Veda. He told all the 4 Rishis, you just take it and do prachar and work on that. And in turn, these Rishis, they trained other students in the same way the Guru Parampara followed. So So before Bhagavan Buddha, Buddha did this kind of a missionary work. The first time Bhagavan Vedavyasa has done. The same style Bhagavan Adishankaracharya also has done. Four Vedas, four students. He has given. This information is given in Srimad Bhagavatam also. You know this orange? You like it? Whenever possible, I will bring this kind of fruits and rice, wheat and all. Now this orange you can split into three. Only one orange, okay? You can split into three section. Say yes?
Yes.
Yeah. You can split two sections. You can eat as it is. You can keep as, what's it, one ball. And according to the, suppose you have one more friend, you just split into two. One more friend added. My part also should go to that. I have to split into three. Other person has come. Before the other person has come, we have to eat it. The fourth person also joined. Ayyo. And you have to split this one orange into four. You agree? In the same way, one Veda can be divided into two, three, or four, according to our need. Because little confusion you will get whenever we study. You just remember this orange. Whenever you take orange, remember the Vedas. Connecting the daily life. Vedas. The concept is very simple. Even though concept is known, connecting that with our daily life, it makes very easy to understand. Vedas can be divided into four. You agree? Mantra, Brahmana, Aranyaka, Upanishad. So one orange into four. Four pieces. Mantra, the poetry, praises the devatas. Brahmana, all yaga yajñas, rituals. Aranyaka, it speaks about upasanas. Upanishad explains the Brahma Vidya. This is the content. Simply we are studying this. But this, what mantra has, what Brahmana, Aranyaka and Upanishad has. The scholars spent a lot of time and they extracted this and they have given us. Very simply we are telling. Mantra as poetry and praising the gods. Brahmana, Yaga Yajna. Aranyaka, Upasanas. Upasana means what, how many kinds of upasana, what kind of upasana you do, where to go, what to get, everything is explained. And the Upanishad, the knowledge portion is Upanishad. You just, sometimes the Vedas are divided into four sections, like this, okay? Sometimes three sections, Karma, Ganda, Jnana, Upasana, Ganda and Jnana, Ganda. Is it okay? Karmakanda, how to purify your heart. Upasana, how to focus. Jnanakanda, how to get released from the bondage. Again, in the karma, mantra and brahmana put together will become karma. Getting it? Aranyaka is upasana. The jnanakanda is nothing but Upanishad. I hope you are getting it.
Yes. Yes.
Ah, show some positive reaction with this. Listen, otherwise, sometimes, you see this kind of division also. Karma Ganda and Jnana Ganda. Getting it? One orange is split into two, Karma Ganda and Jnana Ganda. The Karma Ganda, so that Mantra, Brahmana, Aranyaka put together karma. How to purify your heart, how to get focus. Jnana Ganda, Upanishad. The Jnana Ganda is called Vedanta and Upanishad. So you will not get here after any confusion. What is Upanishad? Vedanta. What is Upanishad? What is Vedanta? Jnana Ganda. In some places they call it Jnana Ganda of Veda. That means this is Jnana Ganda of the Veda. Then what about Upanishad? Getting it? The Jnana Ganda Veda means Upanishad. Okay, the Upanishad and Jnana Ganda. So what about Vedanta? Excuse me, sir, the Vedanta is nothing but the end part of the Veda is called Vedanta. End part words Upanishad. Are you getting it? Jnana or Upanishad is called Vedanta. Very simple. So whenever they say Jnana Ganda or Vedanta or Upanishad, all are same only. I know that. You got it. Sodium chloride and salt. The name is getting changed. Why it is Jnana Ganda? But it speaks about knowledge, self-knowledge, Jnana Ganda. Why it is Vedanta? So end part of the conclusion of the Vedas, Vedanta, Anta. Are you getting it? Why Upanishad? Upanishad, that I'll tell you that. So now our focus is, this 5-6 days, on Upanishad. Not on karma or upasana. Not mantra, brahmana or aranika. Getting it? So slice by slice will go. Very clear. I know you are very clear. Great students. You know, Jnana Ganda means for that knowledge. Vedanta, the conclusion of the Vedas. Very clear. Upanishad. Upanishad. You just split this Upanishad into three sections. Upa. Very near. Upa. Ni means under. Shat, sit. Go near the teacher, sit at his feet and learn. So Upanishad should be studied like this. But interesting part you see in Bhagavad Gita. Teacher is sitting down, the student is sitting up like this. Interesting. But you say, Sarvo Upanishado Gavo, Dogda Gopala Nandanaha, Partho Vasa Sudhir Bhokta, Dugdam Gita Murtam Bhate. Gita Dhyana Sloka says, all Upanishads are what is it? Cows. The essence of the cows is milk. Then Bhagavad Gita is nothing but the essence of Upanishads. Then the Upanishad, what? The Upanishad itself says that go sit at the feet of the teacher and learn. Physically and mentally also. And more than physical. Yeah, then two personality level we have to do. Sometimes if it is not possible, in the modern world it is not possible. Okay, attitude level. Even though Krishna was sitting down and Arjuna was sitting top, but at attitude level, Arjuna came down. Sishyasteham shadimam tvam prapannam. He said, I will be your student. He never said, can you become my teacher? Are you getting it? There's a difference in these two lines. You be, what that? Teacher for me and teach me. That way it shows the ego. You be teacher for me, okay? Getting it? You be teacher. You'll sit like this. You be teacher for me. Can you teach me? No, Arjuna never said. Sishyasteham shadim. I'll be your student. You teach me. So attitude level, even though physically they are sitting like this, attitude level, he came down. Upanishad, same Upanishad. Very interesting part. Thought by thought. Upanishad. Those who want to get more and deeper meaning for Upanishad, I suggest you go to Katha Upanishad introduction given by Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya. Go there and study. So you'll be explaining Upanishad very grammatical way, very, very highly philosophical. Katha Upanishad introduction of Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya. Upanishad, okay? I'm not touching here. Just I'm giving the reference. You also do homework. Okay, life work. Okay, Upanishad. The 10 major Upanishads we have. Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya has written commentary for the 10 major Upanishads. Major means, it does not mean that very big size.
Brihadaranyaka very big size. Chandogya big size, major. But I thought Ishavasyup is minor. Why only 18 mantras? Very small book. It's not the size of the book determines that or that. Major or minor. The subject matter determines what is that, the major or minor. Isha, Kena, Kata, Mundaga, Manduka, Aitari, Taitari, Prashna, Chandogya, Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. All the 10 Upanishads are major Upanishads. Very popular. Even though we have 108 Upanishads, this is the select. This 10 Upanishads are more than enough to get moksha. For the very high level student, only Mandukya is more than enough to get liberation. Sir, I studied Isha, Kena, Kata, Mandukya, everything I studied. This is the last Upanishad for me. Mundaga, I have come here. After this also, if I don't get liberation, what should I do? The next Janma, we have to try. Yeah? Same Upanishad. No, all the Upanishads are talking about the same Brahman. The style is little different from one Upanishad to the other different, other Upanishad. Now see, we have what that? The circle? The circle is the center point of the circle. The center point of the circle is Brahman. Wherever you start from the circle, okay, it reaches the center point in the same way. Whether it's 10 Upanishads or 108 or 1008, all are starting from somewhere in the circumference, some angle of the circumference, and moving towards the center of the circle in the same way. The subject matter is same, but approach is different. That's all. I understood. Suppose we say that I understood what Upanishad says. I understood. But I have a lot of time. 150 years I am living in this world. Why? My prarabdha is like that. So how to spend my time? Then you can take all the Upanishads, study and reflect. Spending time like this. Doing prachara. Okay. And enjoying, reveling in the Upanishad thought. Vedanta vakyeshu sadaramanta. Is it okay? No. Moving to next slide. Just I am giving you very simple the work. Rigveda. Rigveda, you find Aitareya Upanishad. In the bracket I have given Prajnanam Brahma. This Prajnanam Brahma is Mahavakya. I am not touching Mahavakya and all. Just I am telling you Mahavakya. Somewhere you will study this Mahavakya. Just to hear. This Mahavakya Prajnanam Brahma is kept in Aitareya Upanishad. This Upanishad you can see in Rigveda. Because every Veda has got Upanishads. All the four Vedas. Rig, Yaju, Samatharvana. The Yajur Veda you get Isha, Katha, Taittiriya and Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. In the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad you get Mahavakya Aham Brahmasmi. All the Mahavakyas, you get the Upanishads. I think you are going in the clear cut thought. Is it okay? Yeah. In the Yajurveda, you get so many Upanishads. Katha, Taittiriya, Isha, Brihadaranyaka. Samaveda, you get two Upanishads. Kena Upanishad and Chandogya Upanishad. In the Chandogya Upanishad only you get Tattvamasi. Upadeshavakya Mahavakya. Tattvamasi. The 9 times the Rishi repeats Tattvamasi. Chandogya Upanishad. So in Atharvana Veda you get Prashna, Mundaga, Mandukya. In the Mandukya Upanishad you get the Mahavakya Ayamatma Brahma. All the four Mahavakyas you get in the four Upanishads, all the Upanishads are in the Vedas. For our extra study only, this information is given. Otherwise, it will take long time to go through this. Very long time. How to search which book you have to go through. All compiled and I am giving you in one slide. Extra information. Shall we go to next slide? Say yes. Again, this prasthanastraya is very, very popular. You must have heard the word prasthanatraya. Sthana prasthanatraya. Traya means three. Prasthana. These three, what are they? The great books of philosophy. The Hinduism has got these three great pillars. Philosophical books. Upanishads, Brahma Sutra, Bhagavad Gita. The great concrete pillar. You know, concrete pillar or granite pillar, powerful pillar, upon which the whole Sanatana Dharma stands. Again, all the three are explained, same truth. The subject matter is same, but different approach. You know Jaggery? Yes. Say yes?
Yes.
Jaggery. In Tamil, we call it Vellam. In Malayalam, Vellam is different. Vellam is Tannil. Water is Vellam. See, Vellam. Jaggery. Yeah, that is Vellam. Yeah, okay. Yeah, the pronunciation is a little different. Yeah. Vellam. Jaggery. So difference between this, among these three I'm telling, to understand very easily. The Upanishads are like pure jaggery. Pure jag. 100%. Agamark? Yeah, Agamark. The brand, yeah. Pure jaggery is Upanishads. Sweet. You can eat it, taste it. Bhagavad Gita is like the payasam made out of this jaggery. Okay? Payasam. Then there will be, what is it? Semya will be there. Dry grapes will be there. Cashew nuts will be there. Other things, whatever you want, you just put. Whatever you like, you put there. And a very nice fragrance. Payasam. Jaggery you can take very limited amount only. Bhagavad Gita. Payasam you can take 2, 3, 4 cups also. You can keep this in the fridge. After some time, we take and put it in the oven. What is that? Box? Microwave. Put there and eat. Bhagavad Gita. Payasam made out of the Jaggery Upanishad. And I tell you the Brahma Sutra, you know? I do not know. What is that? English I do not know. In Tamil, we call it Kamarkattu. Very hardest, the sweet. Candy. Eh? Very hard, the round shape. The ball shape, small ball shaped candy. Very, very hardest to break it. This is called Kamarkattu in Tamil. English, I do not know. Kamarkattu? Stylish. Very hardest. This is also made up of jaggery wood. But if you take that, you just take with the sweet. You start tasting the sweet. With all enthusiasm, you just to draw all the effort, katak, you are very happy. After that only you found that Kambarkat is not katak. My interesting. Very hard. But even though it is very sweet, it is hard. It is meant for the young people. Young people means that kind of the intellect is needed. Interesting, huh? But the root is jaggery. Upanishad is a root. The Upanishad is very, what is the real and what is the original jaggery. From that one, the Kamarkattu is made. Even though it's a Tamil word, hereafter use in Hindi also. Sometimes in the Hindi word we use in the other language, Kamarkat. Okay? The Brahma Sutra is nothing but the product of jag. Little hardest, that's all. Little harder. Bhagavad Gita is pious. Anyway, so our Gurudev, he did not touch Kamarkattu. People will run away. So he brought this pious for us. Oh. So every house, the big, big fridge, the big, big paisam is there. And even child also can drink, old people, not senior citizen. Senior citizens and young people, anybody can drink. So he took Bhagavad Gita for us. And he brought Upanishads also. This Bhagavad Gita is made out of this jaggery. You just taste this also. That's why he did not touch Brahma Sutra. So he has given homework for us. You study in your life, that's all. If you are okay, take this and study. You understood the difference? Upanishads, Brahma Sutra and Bhagavad Gita, that's all. So people are actually frightening. Suppose, even though I am 70, 75, 80, my teeth is very strong, then you can take Brahma Sutra. People are frightening. Actually, there is no need to get frightened about this. We have to be careful, that's all. Careful. Then we can eat it. Is it okay? Prasthanatraya. And one more thing I'll tell you. So we are very, very familiar with this Prasthanatraya. Brahma Sutra, the powerful pillars. Gurudev uses the powerful pillars. The whole, our temple is made. Bhagavan Vedavyasa brought 18 Puranas. We don't have time to go through 18 Puranas. Just to go through only one Bhagavad Purana, it will take so many years. To get very familiar about the Bhagavad Purana, again and again you have to read. Again, the structure of Bhagavadam is like what the jackfruit. There are so many fruits and sweets I will bring to this class. Yeah. Ramayana, Bhagavadam, all Puranas, Mahabharata. So all these things are nothing but the product or the essence of Upanishad, Brahma Sutra, Bhagavad Gita. So the student of philosophy can go through directly this book and can understand. I don't want any entertainment, sir. I want to get this directly. Tell me what you want. Tell me, that's all. People are not ready to get what they want. Suppose somebody is coming to our house, we are telling that. Or okay, so we are very straight. We are a very straight person. The people are coming to our house and they are talking more than half an hour. And we get irritated. Hey, what is your problem? You tell me what you want. I don't want to have any interest. What do you want? Tell me. I want 10,000 rupees. You should have told this directly. Then you told about your son, your daughter, and your wife, father-in-law, mother-in-law. Then after that only he comes to the end. Therefore, I need 10,000 rupees. You getting it? So people, the mind is ready to get directly. Go to Upanishad, directly get it. If mind is not ready, the mind needs some entertainment, go to Mahabharata. Go to Mahabharata. Go to Upanishad, that Puranas. Have some entertainment. Then finally, the conclusion will be Upanishads. You getting it? Very nicely Bhagavan Vedavyasa brought. So finally we have to come to here only. This is the final door. When we knock the door, the next is moksha. So Bhagavan Vedavyasa brought this, story very nicely in. If you read Bhagavadam. Gajendra Moksha. Gajendra Moksha is nothing but the story he framed very nicely. You know the story I'm not telling. You know the story. Gajendra Moksha, he says very nicely how Gajendra has become. The one king has become Gajendra, the other Gandharvas become crocodile. How they met together. So what happened to this Gajendra? How Gajendra did this prayer? How Bhagavan came and how he released from the crocodile? All the stories he explains. The finally, if you see the whole Gajendra Moksha is nothing but the release of Jiva from the bondage. That's all. Getting it? So that kind of mind is needed, this kind of that entertainment. Through the entertainment, he comes to this. Gajendra is nothing but Jiva. Crocodile is nothing but body, mind, and intellect. The madu, whatever the lake is nothing but samsara. And you just go through Gajendra Moksha, in Gajendra Moksha Stuti, you will not find any devata description. No devata description. Yasmin nidam yatascedam yenedam yeidam swayam yo asmat parasmascha paraha tam prabodhya swayam bhuvam. No description. That means Upanishad sloka. Upanishad mantras kept in the sloka form. For other people also you brought that kind of entertainment. Suppose I don't want Gajendra or crocodile. I have seen everything in my family. All forest animals. Tell me directly, what is moksha? Directly coming to the moment. Direct. The students of philosophy, they come directly to the Upanishad class, okay? Prasthanatriya. This Prasthanatriya, one more information. We have Lagu Prasthanatriya and what is that? Brihat Prasthanatriya. We should not say Lagu opposite Lagu Guru Prasthanatri. No. Brihat Prasthanatri. So all this, the three, Brahma Sutra, Bhagavad Gita and Upanishads come. All these three come under the category of Lagu Prasthan. Lagu means very easy. Easy to get, easy to understand. Brihat Prasthanatri, Khandana Khandana Kadyam. This Khandana Khandana Kadyam is written by the great the person, Sri Harsha. Sri Harsha. Philosophy, high philosophy. And Chitsuki. Chitsuki. Another name of Chitsuki is Tattva Pradipika. So this is written by the great, what is that? The Acharya, Chitsuka Acharya. Chitsuka. Chitsuki. This is written in Nyaya language. Very difficult to understand. I went through this when I did MA philosophy. I didn't understand, but I got first class mark. Yeah, honestly speaking. That's why this is Brihat Prasthanatri. Chitsuki. And Advaita Siddhi. Oppo. Shri Madhusudana Saraswati is Advaita Siddhi. This also, Pancha Mithyatva, he speaks very powerfully. I did this also in MA. MA philosophy I did. Advaita philosophy. Whenever I do first year, second year, I used to take the book which is to be finished in this year. First year of 5 books, second year 5 books, so 10 papers I have to finish. Second year Advaita Siddhi I did. Okay? I took the book, very big book. First time I saw in my life. I heard also, first time. I took that book to get signature from Guruji, Swami Teja Mahinji. First year also he signed all the books. Second year also I took. Swamiji, you just signed all the 5 books. The first year I got first class. Please bless me. Shower more blessings. So that I can get first class. Because when I get first class, then only I can get entry into PhD. Okay? Then Guruji saw this book and he has signed that book. And he looked at me. And looked at the book. Advaita Siddhi. The topmost book in the Advaita philosophy. Topmost. Madhusudana Saraswati Swami. Powerful, what the great devotee, at the same time, powerful philosopher, Advaita Madhusudana Saraswati. Guruji looked at me and looked at this book. He said, hey, he told me, whatever you have, you are going to lose that. After this study. I don't know why. Very toughest book in the Advaita philosophy. Luckily, I saved little. you understood? Oh, powerful. So far, few people has done some critical study of Advaita Siddhi. Some little translation. I do not know whether the complete translation is available for Advaita Siddhi or not. I do not know. But in my knowledge, I have seen one critical study and little translation. That translation, if you see English translation, you feel the original is better than that. Yeah. I'm not telling about that. I'm joking. Just you go through that. Amma. Our Gurudev, if you go to the Lagu Prasthana and the Brigas Prasthana, you go to university. If you want to do Advaita philosophy, go to university, okay? When I did this university course, only three people. The whole course, three people. One guard was at fail mark, other guard was a very border mark guard. I also got little mark, came out. 2 years, the stress I went through. When I finished this, very heavy. Then I understood how our Gurudev made Upanishad Bhagavad Gita so easy for the common man to understand. But you have to go through this book, the real path, the real study from university. If you go and see how they teach and how the book is available, how the translation is available. If you go through that, then you go, what a great compassionate heart. And made it very, very easy for us. Now we are not studying mantra part, brahmana part, aranyaka part. Directly we are sitting here in Upanishad. Actually speaking, we have to go through mantra, brahmana, aranyaka, all this. Getting it? Without doing anything, we are sitting here. No part one, part two, part three. Directly we are here at the door of moksha. You just do mandukya, next moksha. See the compassion. Otherwise, very difficult. Very difficult. Go to Gurukula, they will ask you to go through all the things. First, study Sanskrit. There's no need of study of Sanskrit also. Whatever we know Sanskrit little, with this we manage. We are already familiar with the Hindi. With that, we will read Devanagari. With the transliteration, we study. And we understand the depth of Upanishad as it is. Now you understand the compassionate heart? Oh. Now the subject matter of the Upanishads or Brahma Sutra or Bhagavad Gita, this is Jiva, Ishvara, Jagat, what is Bandha, what is Moksha, what are the sadhanas we have to do to get Moksha. That's all. You take any Upanishad. This is subject matter. How it presents thought by thought is getting, what is that? Different from one Upanishad to other Upanishad, that's all. The subject matter is the same. The presentation is different, that's all. You getting it? Suppose you made upama. Suppose only, okay? You made upama. The father made upama. Because it's very, very simplest and easiest. In a very short time, you make upama. But one more thing, upama is very toughest and very easiest. You agree? Yeah. Suppose the father is making this upama, with over enthusiasm, he pours a little more water. First you will put this. Over what? Upma will become pious. Then mother comes and started shouting as usual. As usual, you made this upma into payasam. Who will eat it? Okay, who will drink it? Very toughest actually. But in a short time you can manage. When you do this, so many guests can be managed very easily. This father is very powerful. Great person. Very nice upma. Daughter comes. The child, what that? The son comes, father-in-law, mother-in-law. All the five people. Okay? The father made very nice, because every time mother is making, that's why I changed the story. Father also should make it. Okay? All the time mother. No! Suppose, just to give a small project. You just give this boy. This boy is studying 10th standard. Okay, you ask this boy to serve all the 5-6 people on the table. How he serves? 50% will be on the table. What is the table? 50% will be there. You know. Mother-in-law. Only little will come. Correct amount will come. That's all. You have to ask for a second round. Okay, right. Father-in-law, he will take whole gundan for the one person. He doesn't. Instead of 6%, he will share a whole upuman for 3%. Because father-in-law, he never served like this. Getting it? Mother comes very perfect. The perfect amount she serves. The amma serves perfect amount, that person will not ask for second round. Mother-in-law, 2-3 rounds. Father-in-law, no round for 3 people. You getting it? Some of this girl studies in the, what that? College. She will take the spoon and serve. She doesn't know the difference between the spoon and a karandi. You getting it? You understood? Yeah. The same product, you ask the same, what are the 5-6 people, the same family, how they serve. The presentation is getting different from one person to other person. In the same way, the upma is same upma, are you getting it? Jiva Isvara Bandha Moksha and Sadhana. The different books are, what are the presenting, different way, that's all. Anyway, the product is upma. You got it? Yeah. You should feel that you have studied all the Upanishads after 5 days. When you go home, they will ask you, how many Upanishads you studied? I know all. Hey, you studied only one? But even though it is only one, I know all. Why? I know subject matter of all the Upanishads. Only the presentation is different from one Upanishad to other Upanishad, that's all. You got it? So no need to feel that I didn't study this. No. If you understand only one Upanishad, very easy to, add one more. I tell you, very easy to add. Thus, if you are a very good businessman, you establish your business in one place. Take 20 years also. One place. All the structure of the company, inside, outside, what do you call it, the infrastructure. All inside, outside, take more time and become master of that business, establish, and the extension is very easy. So a very bad businessman, he will start all the places at the same time. He will not find to focus on one place and so many problems. Whatever the property he has, everything he will lose. It will come with bowl. Go to Himalayas. Lost everything. So establishing the business one place, an extension is very, very easy. Very easy, easy to manage. And he knows what kind of problem will get there. Yes, only one Upanishad, thorough study, then you can add more. Is it okay? Now, we are entering into Mundakopanishad. So this much introduction is enough. Mundakopanishad. Shall we start?
Yes.
Yeah, we'll start in the next class, okay? Yeah, next class we'll start. This much of the basic information is needed. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Avasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.